Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to log on and access the share folder in the course using SAS Studio and SAS Enterprise Miner. First, if you have not done so, please register for the class using the link I emailed you or the same link posted on Canvas. After registering for the course, you should be able to log in SAS. Once you log in, you will see SAS On Demand for Academics site that offers several SAS cloud-based applications for us to use free of charge. This list changes depending on the software that SAS provides, so you may see more applications than this example. The software we use for this course is SAS Enterprise Miner, a data mining application. It is cloud-based, so it does not require any downloading and installation. The only requirement is configuration update on Java. If you click on configuration steps required, it will take us to the website with more detailed instructions on how to verify and update Java. If your Java is not updated, you will need to update a specific version of Java as specified on this website. Please make sure to follow the steps carefully, as different computers may require different steps. I'd like to add that, at this time, SAS On Demand for Academics mainly work on Windows platform. You could try to run on Mac, but it may not work. On my Mac, I could get the application run, but I cannot access the share folder for some unknown reason. If you run SAS Enterprise Miner on Mac and experience the same issue, you can switch to Windows or upload the files to your server account instead of using the share folders. I posted the example dataset and the assignment dataset on Canvas. Nonetheless, I strongly recommend using Windows system to run this application to avoid any technical issues. My videos are also based on Windows version. I understand some of you are using Mac, but the data mining and statistics software on Mac is very limited, so we need to stay with Windows version. After completing the configuration, we'll come back to this site and click on the link SAS Enterprise Miner to open the application. You might want to bookmark this link or save the file main.jnlp to your desktop for easy access. When you open this application, you need to log in using the same username and password. Note that you need to have a strong internet connection to run the application. Otherwise, you will experience slow running or delay in the analysis process. This is SAS Enterprise Miner window. To access the share folder of the course, we need to create a new project. The share folder is a folder on SAS server that is accessible for the instructor and all students in the course. In this folder, I posted the example dataset for the video and the dataset for the assignment. Note that the datasets change by semester, so you need to check Canvas for the update information on datasets in the share folder. We select new project and the create new project window opens showing step 1 of 4. Note that this process might take some time at first, so be patient. Once SAS is done with this step, it will run faster. Click Next. On step 2, we need to enter the project name. I will call it SAS Example. Click Next. On next window, you will see the folder location of the project. Note that this folder is where the project file is located on SAS server, but it is not a share folder. It is only accessible for you. Click Next and click Finish. This is the project we just created. I will explain the interface in another video. To access the share folder, the easiest way is to use project start code. First, you need to make sure to select the project name SAS Example up here. Then we select the three-dot button next to the project start code. It will open the project start code screen. Note that SAS works with libraries instead of actual folders, so we need to identify the library name and the path to the folder we want to work with. This is called libname statement. In order to get the correct libname statement, we go to Canvas, Activity 1.3, and copy and paste the libname statement. Note that libname statement changes every semester, so we will need to check Canvas for the correct one because it will likely be different from this example. Basically, the libname statement has three parts: libname command, library name limited to 8 characters or less, and the path to a folder in quotation marks. At the end, we have to add a semicolon. Click Run Now to run the statement and click OK. To access the shared folder to get the dataset, we select Data Sources. Data Source wizard will open. I will go into more details of this wizard in another video. Click Next. On step 2, we select Browse to find the folder. The Select a SAS table window opens. We can see the library name we have in the libname statement. For example, in this case, we have CH2, CH3, etc. Click on CH2 and SAS will open the corresponding folder with datasets in this folder. For our course, you might see different datasets. We select one data and click Next. And we keep clicking Next until the end and click Finish. Again, I have another video going to each step of this process. Here we see the data set we got from the share folder and added to this project. That is how to access the shared folder in SAS Enterprise Miner. Thank you and bye now.